You're watching ShaQuene Live on MMTV, and this is our second season premiere, and we are ready to show you the life of New York. Are you ready to see? I hope so. Stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
Hello?
Hey, I'm ShaQuene, and you're watching ShaQuene Live on MMTV. And we are here today at Pier 51 talking to the world about 2012. Is it true? Is it not true? Do you believe or don't you? We'll find out very soon. We'll be right back. ShaQuene, and you're watching ShaQuene Live on MMTV, and we're here at the beautiful Pier 51. Okay, so tell us, Tony, we are asking everyone about 2012. Tell us what you believe.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, basically, only God has that decision.
What's your thoughts on 2012?
I don't believe it.
No human being can predict when the world is gonna end.
Tell everyone your name.
My name is Eamon.
Say that again.
Oh, my name is Eamon.
That's wonderful. That's different. Amen. I love that.
Amen.
I love that.
Amen.
What are your thoughts on 2012, December 21st, 2012?
So I've heard of the December 2012, the Mayan calendar and the whole thing. And I think it's sort of cute that everybody thinks that the world's going to end on their watch. And,
yeah.
In their lifetime.
Yes.
And so, no, I don't really believe it, but... But if it would happen, I would probably head south.
If you were to believe in 2012, is there anything that you would do to prepare? Do you think that there's anything that you could do to prepare?
Gather up all the money. What I would do, I would gather up all the money I could get.
Oh my gosh, what can you do to prepare for death? I mean, pretty much probably just have a really good time the night before.
Jets, whatever I could do, trips, however far I can go, and have a good time. It'd be the last day, you know?
What's supposed to happen? Is the whole world supposed to come to an end?
Well, yes, according to the Mayan calendar, there's supposed to be a cataclysmic destruction. Like, it's supposed to eradicate us. We're not supposed to exist anymore.
Every part of the world.
Every part of the earth.
So there's nowhere to hide.
Oh, have a big night with my husband and my friends, party. Who knows? Yeah, just a regular, you know.
I'm sure you try a couple of things you've never tried before.
Maybe if they were presented to me, but I felt creative.
It will not happen, I don't believe.
It sounds terrible and it sounds, yeah, no, I don't believe it.
Vaguely remember hearing something, but we've heard a few of these over the past couple of years, and I'm not sure I believe it.
Well, I find that to be interesting, that a lot of people aren't clear on it. So for all of you out there who aren't clear, the Mayan calendar is an ancient civilization that read the stars, and they believed that on December 21st, 2012, that the world was going to come upon a catastrophe that would be so cataclysmic that no one would be able to survive. So that's what they say. I personally, of course, don't believe it myself.
And so 2012 is just a myth, a rumor, in my opinion. All right, lesson here, he controls the nuclear situation.
Hello?
Well, tell Hi, I'm Deesha Jackson, and I'm with DLJ Sports and Entertainment Connection, a sports and entertainment consulting and marketing firm. I am on ShaQuene Live on MMTV, and I'm here today. I'm at the Capital One Bank building here in the great city of Jersey City in the offices of the Tara Dowdell Group, who I happen to be a client of. I want to welcome Tara to our show. This
Thank
is Tara
you.
Dowdell, who is the CEO of the Tara Dowdell Group.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for taking some time out to talk about yourself and your business today and give some pointers out there to the indie artists and people in the entertainment industry. Well, I'm going to let you do the talking with regard to your business and yourself. So tell us a little bit about the Tara Dowdell Group and what they do.
Well, Tara Dowdell Group is a strategic consulting and marketing firm. We help people identify opportunities, and then once we've identified those opportunities where they can either grow their business, grow their brand, grow their organization, once we've identified those opportunities, then we help them develop a strategy to achieve those opportunities, to reach those goals that they have set for themselves. And so that's in a nutshell what we do. Our service areas are relationship building, because what a lot of people don't realize is that relationships are everything in business. They basically make the trains run on time.
Right.
Relationships are what drives business. They have always driven business, and the people that don't understand that don't excel to the extent that the people who do. It's like the old saying goes, it's not about what you know, but who you know.
Mm-hmm.
So we help people know the right people. So that's one of our service areas. We also provide public relations work as well, and public relations, bread and butter, press releases, media advisory, pitching our clients to get them on different shows, blogs, magazines, to get them that coverage in order to attain that exposure so that people are aware of who they are. And if people know you're out there, you're more likely to get business or get opportunities. So we help on that front as well. We also help with branding. It's so important for people when they're trying to get a product out there or get themselves out there, that they have a very strong, identifiable brand so that when people see that brand, it's recognizable, because people tend to move towards familiarity. So if you're familiar with a brand, you're going to feel more likely closer to it. You're going to more likely want to use something that you know about. So we try to help people become known commodities, and branding is a part of that effort. And then the last area that we offer is strategic planning, because you got to have a plan. Plan your work and work your plan.
That's right.
So a lot of people don't realize the value of having a very strong, focused, comprehensive plan to get from point A to point B. And so we develop marketing plans for people. Again, as I mentioned at the top, what we do is help them identify those opportunities, and that's all part of strategic planning, because you have to figure out where the opportunities are that you want to pursue. Otherwise, you're just sort of wandering out there in the wilderness with no real direction. So we provide that direction.
Wow, that is a lot that she does.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to talk a little bit about, it seems like you've been doing this for a long time, or at least for a few years. And I want the audience to kind of know about you and who you are as a person. Can you tell us a little bit about your background and what you've done in entertainment as well?
Well, I do have my own experience in entertainment as well. I was on the third season of the show, The Apprentice, the reality show. I competed on that, and I unfortunately got fired. But
that's all right.
But I was selected, and it was a great experience. I was selected over out of a million people, and again, it sort of speaks to that importance of exposure. So it gave me exposure, it made me known to people, and that yielded and created opportunities for me, and then I leveraged those opportunities. So in addition to also starting the Tara Dowdell Group, because my background is politics, that's where I actually began my career, working in politics. I worked in the governor's office. I worked for the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. On the communication side, I worked for the shipping arm of the agency. So when all the ships come in with the products that we all buy, that was a part of the Port Authority where I worked. And I managed the multi-billion dollar redevelopment program. For that program, I provided the marketing and the strategic planning and the PR to promote that program to folks, so that people know why we're spending all this money to do this redevelopment of the ports where the ships come in with our products.
Excellent. You have a very interesting background. Well, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back to speak to Miss Tara Dowdell a little bit more about the marketing and PR in her business and how it can help you. Stay tuned. Hi, welcome back. Thank you for staying tuned to ShaQuene Live on MMTV. I'm Deesha Jackson. And again, we're here with Tara Dowdell, who is the CEO of the Tara Dowdell Group. And we've just heard some very interesting things about her business as well as her background. Tara, tell us a little bit about maybe some pointers, or before we even get to pointers, do you want to talk to the audience about any of your clients and any important things happening with your clients or things that you can divulge without violating any confidentiality agreements that you have? And just to give them an idea of how you kind of do the substance of what you do.
Well, thank you for asking, Deesha. So we have a very diverse array of clients. And first, let me start by saying the Tara Dowdell Group, in addition to being a strategic consulting and marketing company, in addition to that, we also focus on socially conscious businesses, organizations, individuals. So a lot of the people that we work with and the companies that we work with and the organizations that we work with do things that help the community. So there's a double bottom line in terms of what they do. And so that's another area where we are, that is the primary area of focus. And I'm very busy, so now my cell phone's ringing, disrupting the segment, so apologies for that. But clients call on Saturdays too. But with respect to what we do and our client base, so we represent a sampling of some of our clients would be real estate development companies. So we work with real estate developers that do urban redevelopment projects. So our clients go into urban areas, they typically build affordable housing so that the people who live in those areas can afford to live in these nicer, newer buildings. All of our clients also do green buildings. So their projects are environmentally sustainable projects. And a lot of people don't know this, but when you look at urban centers, a lot of the urban centers, we have a high degree of asthma because of the air quality. So the buildings that they build are designed in a way so that it does not impact people. A lot of people don't know the way you build the building can impact your health because that's where you sleep, that's where you live. If the quality of the products are bad, if there are fumes coming from the paint, that all impacts your health. And so our clients take that into consideration. So I'm proud to work with people like that. We also do work for government agencies, which is also enjoyable work. And one of our clients, Essex County, New Jersey, actually has a program for small business owners, and my firm is the marketing consultant for that program. And so it really helps small business owners to access some of those government resources that the big businesses already know how to get to. And so I'm very proud of the work that we do with Essex County as well. And that's just a sampling of our clients. I don't want to take up too much of the show time on
that.
Wow.
That's really, really interesting, and it seems like you have a wide array of clients, and what's really good is the socially conscious purpose when you're going after clients and you're dealing with them. That really gives it, makes you feel good,
yes.
Makes the clients feel good that you want to help to kind of do something socially conscious. And of course, you know, how the universe works, you know, you do good things are going to come back to you.
Yes.
So that's why you're very successful. Let's talk a little bit about some pointers maybe that you could give to some of the indie artists when we come back from our break.
Okay.
So stay tuned because we're going to have Tara talk to you maybe about some pointers with regard to marketing and PR when you're out there doing your indie thing in the entertainment industry. Deesha Jackson on ShaQuene Live on MMTV. Stay tuned.
Everybody talks.
Hi, welcome back. Deesha Jackson with DLJ Sports and Entertainment Connection on ShaQuene Live on MMTV, and I am interviewing Tara Dowdell from the Tara Dowdell Group. And we're going to talk to her about some pointers for you out there in the entertainment industry with regard to marketing as well as PR. But there's something very interesting about Tara, in addition to being CEO of this wonderful marketing, PR, and business development firm, she also appears on TV, and some of you may have seen her. You want to tell our audience a little bit about what you do on TV?
Well, I also am a political commentator, and so I appear regularly on CNN, Fox News, Fox Business, Fox 5 New York, Good Day New York, that show that comes on in the morning, and Hot 97 Street Soldiers, the radio show. So I'm regularly on those shows commenting on the latest political topics, on government, different laws and policies that are coming out by our government and what impact it has on communities. So that's another thing that I do as well, because as I mentioned earlier, my original background, where I come from, is actually politics originally before I started my own firm.
Excellent. So I thought that was an interesting tidbit for you guys who are out there watching the news. Look for Tara. And you know what? In addition to looking for her, if you see her and you like her, send in an email and tell them that you like her and that she should appear more regularly. We got to help each other out. And that's how we help each other out. She's excellent. She knows her stuff. And I think you will enjoy when she's on TV doing her thing. Well, let's talk a little bit about any pointers. You've been in the marketing and PR and business development and kind of business strategy and plans. What can you tell the entertainment folks and even the sports folks and business out there, and indie artists and music industry? Give them some pointers that they may want to consider in doing marketing and PR.
Well, I'm glad you asked that question, Deesha, because I think a lot of people don't recognize the full power and value of marketing and how very important it is to anyone's brand in terms of getting that brand more known, in terms of growing that brand and growing a following. And so one of the things I think that the most important thing, in my opinion, is consistency. And I don't think people realize the value of consistency. Marketing is an ongoing process. You can't do a quick marketing campaign and expect everything to happen. It's just that the world just doesn't work that way. So it's all about being consistent. Whether you're on social media, whether you are taking out advertisements, you have to have that consistency, because think about it this way. If while you're not being consistent, all your competition is. So your value proposition is making sure that you are consistently out there, getting your message out there to your target audience. And so that's so important. The second thing that I would say is very important is don't be, as my mom would say, a penny wise and a pound foolish. And what I mean by that is, to be very simple, don't be cheap. When it comes to your marketing materials, that is a reflection of you. Find the money to put together very high quality marketing materials. When you hand someone a business card, they're going to draw a conclusion about you and your value and what your business can offer based on that card. So make sure you have a high quality business card, because that's all the person's going to get. And within that 3 seconds, they're going to make a determination about whether they want to deal with you or not. So do that, put the money up front to get your name out there. And nowadays, the music industry, and I'll go to my third point, but before I do, the music industry, Deesha, as you know very well, given your line of work, is that the music industry has changed tremendously. And also, whether even for authors, the publishing industry has changed. There was a time when the record companies or the publishing companies would do everything for you. Now you have to do your own marketing. You have to build your own brand.
That's true.
And the beauty of it, though, the good news is that social media allows you to very inexpensively promote your brand. Because if you have an internet connection, you basically can promote your brand via all the big sites, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, YouTube, Flickr. All of those large social media platforms have now given you direct access to people. And so that's so very important. But again, it goes back to my first point. You have to be consistent. If you're on Twitter and you're not responding and engaging the people who are following you, then they're going to lose interest in you. If you're not putting content out there on a consistent basis, people will lose interest and they will forget about you. So that's why that's so important. And the last thing that I would say with respect, and actually let me make one more point about the value of social media. In this country, the United States of America, 245 million people, and we only have 300 million people in this country.
Wow.
245 million people are internet users in the United States of America.
Wow.
Of that number, 80% of those internet users are on Facebook, are reached by some sort of social media. So if you are not consistently and effectively utilizing and leveraging social media, then you're missing out on that 245, that 80% of that 245 million people. So that's something that I think people really need to understand when they're thinking about social media. And so before I get to my third point, I want to recap. So consistency is key. Consistency in terms of getting your name out there and not treating it as something that you do once and hope everything happens. It's an ongoing process. Number two, don't be a penny wise and a pound foolish. Don't be cheap when it comes to your marketing materials, because that's all people have to make a determination about you. And if you're an artist on that same front, if you're going to put a demo out there, make it high quality. Go to a studio. Use, you know, the best equipment. Use good sound engineers and make that investment, because you're investing in you. And so that way the quality of your music is better, because people will get distracted if there's sound in the background and it's scratchy and all of these things. People, that will distract people, and it will distract from your abilities and your voice and what you're putting out there. So that's another area where I think people have to be very careful. I mean, I'm laughing about it, but it, you know, you don't want to be the butt of the joke.
That's
another area. And then the third area that I would say with respect to marketing and something very important is build relationships.
Right.
Relationships, as I mentioned earlier in the segment, relationships are very important. Get to know the right people. Yes. And most importantly, once you meet a connection, follow up.
That's right.
Follow through. Because I meet so many people and they don't follow up. And then remember, the people that you meet that you want to know, that are connections you want to have, they're very busy. So if they don't get back to you right away, wait and then send them another email.
Amen.
But be politely persistent. Don't be annoying persistent. Be politely persistent.
That's right.
And so make sure that you say, I just want to check in again. Go that extra mile. Send a handwritten note to someone. People love handwritten notes. But it's all about the extra mile. That's going to be the difference between your success and your lack thereof, or no success at all, lack thereof.
Excellent. Those are some wonderful, wonderful points. And I hope you guys wrote those things down out there in the entertainment industry and sports industry for your businesses with regard to PR and marketing. Those are some excellent points. Tara Dowdell, the CEO of the Tara Dowdell Group, marketing, PR, business development. You see her address, you see her phone number, give her a call if you need those kinds of services. She's excellent at what she does. My business is a client, so I can attest to the hard work that she does, and her knowledge base that she has really, really is helpful. I'm Deesha Jackson. I'm with DLJ Sports and Entertainment Connection. That's DLJSEC.com. And I am on the ShaQuene Live show on MMTV. Thank you again for tuning in. We will definitely see you next time. God bless.
Hey, you know who I am. I'm ShaQuene, and of course you're watching ShaQuene Live on MMTV. And we had a wonderful day out here in New York, dealing with the entrepreneurs and the artists and everyone who is a New Yorker. But one thing, to the Parks Department and the police of New York, they were trying to shut us down earlier and allow us not to perform, and told us that we needed a permit. So for all you independent filmers out there and independent people who come into parks and do things, know this, you do not need a permit to film in this setting with one camera just set up. You do not need a permit to have your camera out and get the life of New York. Nor would you ever need to get $1 million insurance to make sure that you didn't break anything in this beautiful park in the wonderful New York City. Now, New York, we love you. And of course, you know, you're watching ShaQuene Live on MMTV. And this is our second season. And you better get ready, because it only goes up from here. We'll see you next week. Deuces.
Hello. Set the camera off, please.